The Jacinto 7 processors implement a hierarchical approach to device configuration and management. A small microcontroller called the Device Management and Security Controller, or DMSC, is responsible for all security configuration and much of the common resource configuration of the Jacinto 7 SoC. In this section, I will give a brief overview of this concept. The DMSC is located in the Safety MCU domain and is composed of a closed ARM Cortex M3 core running TI firmware. This subsystem effectively abstracts much of the device configuration from the software running on the other cores. These configurations include clocking, power, quality of service settings, event and interrupt configurations, and allocation of DMA resources. The DMSC also owns all device firewall configurations, all security keys, and any secure sensitive resources in the system, such as the cryptography accelerators. All configuration requests for configuration of these resources must go through a secure messaging mechanism such that the DMSC can effectively enforce all secure policies for the system. Instrumental to the overall system performance of the Jacinto 7 processors are the memory architecture and the movement of data across the SoC. It is important to keep data flowing to all the various cores so that the majority of their time is spent processing and not stalling. In this section, I will describe the overall memory system on the SoC and the various components which deal with data movement and event or message management. Jacinto 7 supports a multi-level memory system in which most CPUs have one or two levels of caches, and in some cases, such as the R5 cores, some additional low-latency local RAM memories. The multi-core shared memory controller, or MESMIC, provides access to a third level of system cache or RAM. Depending on the device derivative, this L3 RAM or cache may be up to 8 megabytes in size. This is available to be shared across cores in a coherent manner. For any shared space, the MESMIC can enforce CPU cache coherency for the A72 and the C71X DSP cores. For all other masters and CPU cores, the shared L3 cache is ensured to be coherent for I/O data. Some L3 may also be allocated for use as direct RAM. This is useful in cases such as the deep learning processing for the C71X and MMA. The MESMIC also provides access to external DDR memory. The DDR memory bandwidth must be carefully managed to ensure quality service for real-time tasks and to make effective and efficient use of the available bandwidth. The DDR interface supports LPDDR4 or LPDDR4X protocols at rates up to DDR3733. The controller also implements inline ECC, such that no additional DDR memory devices are required to be populated in the system. This saves system cost. A small ECC context cache ensures minimal impact to the performance of the DDR when using ECC. Aside from CPU cores and master peripherals, there are also several DMA engines which can move data to and from the various peripherals and memories, and also manage synchronization events and message data between the cores. The overall SoC implements a tiered bus fabric, which uses prioritization and credits within MESMIC to ensure quality of service for real-time traffic. This slide lists the many components which deal with data movement on the SoC. The primary DMAs on the device are the Data Routing Unit, or DRU, which moves data to and from the MESMIC L3, primarily for C7X and MMA, and then two instances of Unified DMA, or UDMA, one located in the main domain and one in the Safety MCU domain. The UDMA is the DMA engine which performs the majority of system block copies and services data movement for any peripheral which does not have its own embedded DMA master. A key feature of the UDMA architecture is that it has distributed buffering components called peripheral DMA, or PDMA, which are located closer to key peripherals on the device and allow local buffering to prevent overflow or underflow on real-time peripherals. The UDMA is designed specifically to enable virtualization and ownership of separate threads or data flows between different isolated software tasks. This is key for safety and security isolation. The UDMAs are located in what is called the Navigator Subsystem, or NAVSS. The Navigator is really a collection of all IPs dealing with data movement, message movement, and event management. The Navigator also contains all the virtualization components, which will be covered in a subsequent section. The navigator houses all interrupt and DMA event aggregation and routing, which is highly configurable as there are thousands of peripheral interrupts and events which may be optionally associated with the various cores or DMA. The navigator also contains all inter-processor communication mechanisms, which include a secure proxy mechanism, allowing secure messaging to the security controller or DMSC, and also traditional mailbox and spin locks for hardware semaphores. Finally, the navigator provides several time synchronization features, including central timestamping, which can be used with various peripherals to correlate system time, and a timer manager, which is a very large bank of timers which facilitates traffic management for improved determinism in the system.
Thank you for watching this training. For more information, refer to the links shown. For questions about this training, go to the processor forums at ede.ti.com.